be learning about a literary device called ironing. But before we do that, I want you to review some of the words that we've talked about in the last few weeks with your table partners. What I want you to do is you each have all of the notes. I want you to go over the word that's on the sheet. I want you to read the definition, which is in red on your notes. And I want you to talk about the illustration that is on your sheet so that you kind of have a visual to remember what the word means. So I will give you just a few minutes to go over that. Go.
Okay, so my word is humor, and it means the quality of being amusing or comic, especially as expressed in literature or speech. And the picture is a meme, and it says the face I make when I see memes with incorrect grammar and spelling. And that's humorous because it shows Robert Downey Jr. being annoyed that people can't spell or grammatically.
Why don't you share the picture with them? Because that the joke really doesn't make, you know, it's not really a joke unless you can see the picture.
This is the picture.
And the definition was the position from which something or someone is observed. And the picture is a king saying, try to see things from his point of view, like to the crowd so they understand them, kind of.
Okay, are there any questions on that quick review that you did with those three words? Suspense, humor, point of view. Okay. So if you noticed, when you were looking at your notes, the point of view we're going to be talking about isn't first person, second person, third person, which we learned last quarter. When I'm talking about point of view with this lesson, we're talking about how each person is kind of interpreting or what their point of view is. And your picture had shown the king, who's way up here, his point of view is much different than the common people down here. Everything he can see out miles and miles away, right, from his point of view, but the people on the ground can't really see what he's seeing. So that's what I'm kind of talking about with different points of view. One other one that I want to go over in which you have your notes in, but I'm just gonna show you on the board here, is literary device. Literary device. Who remembers what a literary device is? Ashley.
It's a technique that a writer uses to enhance their writing and make it have special effect almost.
Yes. What would be some examples of literary devices that we have used?
Simile.
Jake. Simile. Very good. Do you recall what a simile is?
Comparing two things using like or as.
Very good. Simile, comparing two things using like or as. What are some other literary devices that we've studied? Ashley.
An allusion.
Allusion, very good. What else? Carly.
A metaphor.
Metaphor, excellent, excellent. Well, dramatic irony is a literary device. So, what we are going to do today is, if you notice on the screen, we are going to eventually be talking about three different types of irony. We have situational, verbal, and dramatic, which we will go over the next 2 days. But the one we're going to be working on today is called dramatic irony. So, let's just, first of all, define generally and in a broad sense what irony is. Now, on your guided notes that I have provided for each of you, you will be reading along as I read out loud, and some of you have to fill in more words than others, but that's okay. Fill in the words that are missing on your guided notes. Irony, defined in its most simple terms, is a difference between appearance and reality. Now, I'm going to show you kind of a cute video that is going to explain that more in depth. So we're going to go on to the next slide. I've already talked about the three main types of irony. We have verbal irony, dramatic irony, situational irony. Please write those down on your notes. Now, I've given a couple of illustrated examples. We'll get back to those as we define each of these things. All right, so let's jump right in. First, we're just going to today study dramatic irony. Dramatic irony, it is when the audience or reader knows something that the characters do not know. Any actions or words from the character about this thing are ironic to the audience because we know better. All right, so I know these notes might be a little bit confusing to you, so I found a couple of videos to help you better understand what dramatic irony is. So this first video is just basically, you don't need to write anything down, so your pens can be down. It's going to show you what dramatic irony is. I want to stop right here now and draw your attention to our content objectives and language objectives. What we are going to be doing, which is the next part of our lesson. So our content objectives, the students will be able to identify dramatic irony and explain how it creates humor or suspense by comparing the points of view of the characters to the audience. That is what we are going to be working on today. Our language objectives, for those of you that are still working on understanding things in English. Students will listen to and watch, while reading closed caption, short media clips, orally identify the dramatic irony, discuss the effects on the characters and audience, and record their answers into a graphic organizer. So we're going to be doing a lot of practicing of reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Which is nothing new to you. Okay, so are there any questions so far? No? Okay, let's go to the next slide. All right, so effects of dramatic irony. Dramatic irony has a direct effect on the audience or reader. It can add humor, suspense, despair, or anger. Please make sure you're writing that down on your guided notes. Let's talk a little bit about these three illustrations. Humor. So what we have here is we have a prisoner trying to escape by digging underground out of jail. There's an out. Okay, so now what I want you to do with your group is, first I want you to discuss what happened in the video, and then, without writing down, right now we're just discussing, I want you, using the word dramatic irony, I want you to talk a little bit about what happened in that clip, why it's dramatic irony, and what effect did it have on you as the audience watching that? Flip, I want you to discuss, is that dramatic irony? Why is that dramatic irony? And what the reaction of the characters were, and what the reaction of the audience would probably be. All right, go ahead and discuss that as a group.
I think it is dramatic irony because the audience and a couple of the characters know something that other people don't know, and to the audience it's funny, but to the characters it's horrifying.
our degree and then going back to the beginning of the class of being the humor part more. Because everyone thinks it's a piece of food and it's chocolate.
All right, I heard some great discussion around here. Let's share some of our answers. So, what was the dramatic irony in that clip? Carly.
So, like, the girl threw the candy bar in the pool, but nobody saw her do it, so everyone just assumed that it was a piece of poop. So then, like, you know, we knew that it was just a candy bar, so when the guy, like, took a bite of it, the girl passed out thinking that he was eating poop.
Right, so we knew it was a candy bar. The characters did not know that, which had a great effect on the audience. So where it says, why is it ironic? I would like you to write, the characters in the movie think that the Baby Ruth candy bar is a piece of poop. The audience knows that it's actually just candy bar. So what effect did it have on the audience?
They thought it was funny.
They thought it was funny. Very good. And I heard some students even use the word humor, which we reviewed at the beginning of the class. So write down in the effect on the audience, funny, humorous, hilarious. I'm going to go ahead and put those answers on the screen. Next slide, please. And actually, we discussed this already, so we're going to do the next slide. Check your answer. The scene in the movie Caddyshack is ironic because the characters in the movie think that the Baby Ruth candy bar is a piece of poop floating in the swimming pool. The audience knows that it is actually just a chocolate candy bar. So, for those of you that are filling in words, you have your answers up on the board. The rest of you, make sure you just have that idea. All right, so what we're gonna do, and I wanna, I know you don't have your Chromebooks out right now, but I wanna let you know I sent this PowerPoint to you on your Chromebooks, which you will need to do the next task. If you notice on the back of your notes, there are three more clips that I want you to do in your small group. So what you will do is one of you will go get your Chromebook, set it where everyone can see it, and using your headphones and your extension so that all three of you or four of you can hook in. I want you to go to Google Classroom, next slide. Okay, what you're gonna see though is you're gonna see the links to Toy Story, The Dark Knight, and Shrek. Those, you just have to click on those words. It's a link, it will bring you right to the movie clip. So what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be watching the movie clip just like we did with Caddyshack. You are going to discuss the questions, which were on the third slide from the end. You're going to discuss these five questions, and then you are going to record your answers, just like we did for Caddyshack in Why Is It Ironic and the Effect on the Audience. So while you are doing that, I will be walking around assisting anyone who needs help. If you have questions, raise your hands. If you finish before the others, then you can go into your independent reading, or of course you can always go on Quizlet or quizzes and practice your word lists. Are there any questions on what you will be